Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel.
In this video, we will discuss Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. This reaction is similar to Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. So before going to this topic, let me remind you what is Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction and the similarities between these two reactions. In Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, benzene reacts with alkyl halide in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 to form alkyl benzene. While in Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, instead of alkyl halide, benzene reacts with this acyl halide to form acyl benzene. So, only difference is, in place of alkyl halide, we use acyl halide. So, we will get acyl benzene instead of alkyl benzene. If you want to know the mechanism of this Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, then please go and watch my previous video. Now, let us discuss a particular reaction. So when benzene reacts with acetyl chloride, in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 to form acetophenol. That is, when this benzene reacts with acetyl chloride, that is CH3COCl, in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 to form acetophenol plus HCl. So, this is our benzene. This is our acetophenol. Let us discuss the mechanism of this Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Its mechanism is quite similar to Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Step 1, that is the generation of electrophile. Here, the acid chloride reacts with AlCl3 catalyst to form the electrophile. That is, one of the lone pair of this chlorine atom attacks this AlCl3, which is electron deficient, to form CH3Cl AlCl3, and this chlorine will be positively charged and this will be your negatively charged. Then the carbon chlorine bond becomes polarized and this bond will break. Then this species will generated plus AlCl4 minus, which is in resonance with AlCl3 plus Cl minus. So this is our electrophile, which is called acylium ion. This electrophile acylium ion is resonance stabilized. That is, when this lone pair migrates here, then we will get another resonating structure, which is looks like this. So this is our electrophile, this is also our electrophile, but the actual electrophile is this species, because here carbon is positively charged and here oxygen is positively charged, which is quietly unstable, because oxygen is an electronegative atom. Again, here carbon has 6 electrons, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and its octet is incomplete. So this acts as an electrophile. But here oxygen has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that is its octet is completely fulfilled, so it can't act as an electrophile. But in most of the books they are using this is the electrophile, but actual electrophile is this species. Step 2 is the attack of electrophile by the benzene ring to form a sigma complex. That is, benzene reacts with this electrophile, which is formed in the first step, to form a sigma complex. So we will get this species, which is resonance stabilized. So this is our sigma complex. Step 3 is the loss of a proton to form the final substitution product. That is, the sigma complex formed in the first step loses one proton to form the final substitution proton. And this proton will be taken up by AlCl4 ion or Cl4- ion, which is formed in the first step. So this will attack this proton, and this bond will migrate here to form the final substitution product. That is our acetophenone plus HCl. So this is the mechanism of this Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Important note: unlike polyalkylation, we will not get polyacylation product in Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, because here the product formed is a ketone, and you all know that all ketones are metadirecting electron withdrawing group. That is, they withdraw electron density from benzene and deactivates the benzene ring for further substitution reaction. So in place of polyacylated product, we will get only monoacylated product. Again, here we will not get any rearrangement product. Now if you want to convert this acyl benzene, which is formed in this reaction, to alkyl benzene, then we have to reduce this ketone group. There are many methods to convert this ketone group to this methylene group. One of these is Clemmensen reduction. That is, when this ketone reacts with zinc mercury amalgam in presence of HCl and heat, then this group will convert to this group. This reaction is known as Clemmensen reduction. Or you can use Old-Plisnor reduction. That is, when this reaction reacts with hydrazine, that is NH2NH2, in presence of a strong base and heat, then this group will convert to this group. This reduction is known as Old-Plisnor reduction. So this is how you can convert this acyl benzene to alkyl benzene. So this is all about Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. Stay tuned for more videos. Thank you.